broke it.
Golly, see, I was smacking it, and I broke it.
Yeah, he broke our camping axe.
That's what you get for paying $5.
I know. Now it's a hammer.
That camping axe has been in our family for a billion years.
Now you can get rid of that hammer.
Dang. What, might this hammer?
Oh, see, that's the thing about these. They last forever.
Looks like the thing is coming out, though.
Yeah, it does that because I...
That's been his hammer for a long time, too.
But well, I can still use it. Well, that looks kind of small now.
Bummer.
No, this is loose because I hold it back here so far.
Oh.
And so it slides.
Yeah,
it's not glued on anymore.
He's built many of buildings with that hammer. How heavy is that hammer?
900 pounds.
That's heavy.
22 ounce.
22?
22 ounce S-wing.
Yeah, I was trying to use it and it's heavy. All right, well,
so much for that.
It ain't funny.
No, it's really not because I've had that axe for a long time.
Yeah, we just went past Harbor Freight, just up the road, not too far from here.
Well, maybe we can stop back there.
I don't know if I want a Harbor Freight one now.
Well, that's not a Harbor Freight. That's a Coleman, I believe.
Oh,
is it? What is
it? I don't know what it is. Oh, it is.
Yeah, I bought
Maybe
that.
I need to go back to Coleman and say, what up? See, the head, this part came off the other day.
Yeah, it
That's
did.
Why it spun around.
Well, I don't think that they're meant to be hit with a hammer.
They are. That's why they have that on that side.
Oh, okay, maybe. Well, that ain't going to work. That would make a good... It would make a good safety device in the front, in the back end of the camper at night when crazy people knock on our door at 4 in the morning.
It would work better if it had the blade on it, though. No, I don't have $18.37. Go away. Bummer.
Well, you made a nice... Well, I made the fire. You've been stoking the fire. What do you call it? Stoking?
Stoking.
Stoking the fire.
Oh,
all right.
4X.
We'll have to figure out a different... Well, we only have 2 pieces of wood left, so...
Well, I could beat this in and then smack on top of it.
There you go.
Got a pile over there, I think.
Yeah, your wood is a lot better than our wood.
It is.
I came and got some this morning. There you go.
Yeah, as long as you don't hit too tight of a spot. Or, here, Aja, you hold it and I'll hit your hand.
Okay.
Oh, all it'll take is one time for me to hit my hand and it'll be done.
Oh, well, now
oh, okay. Now, yeah, there you go.
Good job. You're still making it work.
Oh, I know. Oh. Okay, that's exhausting.
Well, we got lucky. They are picking up the garbage today. And Scotty just went and talked to him, so they're gonna go ahead and drive right down here and pick up all the stuff we picked up. So that will be nice. Well, that was a nice trade. We gave them all the garbage, and then they gave us all these nice black bags. So that was a good trade.
That was pretty easy.
I know, right?
Right here, pickup service and everything.
We didn't have to put it in our vehicle to take it down there, so that worked out just perfect.
And I didn't have to try getting into those things even after they emptied them, and I don't think... Obviously, they don't do the big dumpster or anything.
Right. No, I think those guys are on work release, maybe.
Yeah.
Well, I'm just happy to get out. County jail or something.
And they said that the park over there, the other one,
yeah,
that they're opening probably Memorial Weekend, and now they're working on putting a fishing dock out there.
Okay, so that's Ray, I think it's called Ray's Campground. It's the campground we went to the other day, and it was closed down.
Yeah, so they're really decking that out. Unfortunately, we won't be here. But
right.
Oh, well.
That's all right.
We'll return.
You always know when the season's about to start for camping. Because the outhouses get delivered. I'm surprised they didn't have outhouses in here to begin with, because there are a lot of people here. So, that's always a good thing for people who need them. We have some of the sweetest subscribers, you guys. All of you guys. Rita was camping across the lake and saw us and came over and visited with us yesterday. Really sweet. Hi, Rita, if you're listening. And thank you. I didn't get to say thank you. I was preoccupied in here. She was getting ready to leave, and she dropped us off some Jiffy Blueberry Muffin Mix. And you can make pancakes with these. We were talking about this yesterday, about how great little Jiffy boxes are for camping and just making like single serve stuff. But anyways, I will definitely use those and make something yummy. And thank you again, Rita. Scotty just came in and actually said there was another side to this. I didn't even see that. She was kind enough to write down some different stops for us. That was nice. Thank you again, Rita. That's very sweet and kind of you. I am going to make some hamburger bean soup today. It just, it's going to be hot out today, but for some reason bean soup just sounds really good. And I didn't soak my beans last night, so I'm going to use, on the back of the package, they have a quick cook recipe, and it's basically you bring it to a rapid boil, reduce heat, cover, and continue boiling for 1.5 hours, and you stir occasionally, and then you can simmer it for about 30 to 45 minutes. I will actually simmer it for a lot longer than that. And I know I've shown you guys bean soup recipes before, but my recipes are always different. So I thought, well, maybe somebody would like this one. I'm going to put hamburger in it and some other vegetables. Basically, I'm just getting the water to come up to a boil. I put just a little under a half a bag of beans in here. And I rinsed them first before I put them in here. So, and then it calls for 10 cups of water to boil. I just poured in enough water for what I know that I'm gonna want for my soup. So that's just up to you. If you feel like you have to put more water in there, put more water in there, depending on how many people you're gonna feed. It will just be Scott and I and nausea. And then, if you want less, just do less. Or follow the recipe on the back of the thing. So, I'm just going to get that boiling, and then I'll show you guys what else I do. Alright, so I've got it boiling, and I went ahead and I turned my stove down to 4, but I think I'm going to take it down just a little bit more. You're supposed to continue to let it boil, covered. But you don't do a rapid boil, so I'm going to turn it down just a little bit more, down to the 3, and then that should be good. Alright, so I've got my beans still on a little bit of a boil, and I'm going to go ahead and turn it down now to low, because it doesn't need to boil anymore. It's been about an hour and a half. And I put in some beef stew mix spices. And I usually would just put in some broth, but I didn't have any. I happened to have a packet for beef stew, so I thought, okay, I'm going to put hamburger in there, so I want to have some kind of a beef flavor to it. So that's what I did there. I've got my onions, my celery cut up, which I'll put in there in just a minute after I get that stirred down. I'm going to put some tomato sauce in there because I like a little bit of a tomato-y flavor. And I didn't have any tomatoes, stewed tomatoes. I used them up the other day. My celery and my onion in there. Oop, jumping ship. And then I'm gonna put some barley in there. I love barley. And that usually only takes about 45 minutes to cook up, but because I'm just gonna simmer it, I'm just gonna put it in now and it will cook up during the day. I am gonna put a little bit of Greek seasoning in there. Somebody had mentioned that I had put Greek seasoning in an Italian dish when I made that spaghetti. I put Greek seasoning in everything. It's kind of like garlic. I put it in everything. And I'm just about out of garlic. I've used all my fresh garlic. I've used all my canned garlic. And I just used all my powdered garlic. I need to go stock up my pantry. Then I'm going to put just a little bit of, let me see here. Where is it? And I'm going to put a little bit of celery salt in there. I'm going to go ahead and let this simmer for the rest of the day, and then I'll add my meats probably about the last hour. I've got my hamburger all fried up and in the pot, and my pot is just about full. The bacon's just about done browning, and I'll put that back over there and put the lid on and just simmer it. Alright, got my bacon all fried up. Just gonna mix it all in. My hamburger. I did put a little bit of Worcestershire, however you want to say it, in my hamburger just to give it a little bit of flavor. And that's it. So that's what it's looking like. Yum. Gonna be a good dinner. Well, I almost forgot to show you guys the finished stuff. We've all had lunch and dinner. This is what we had for both meals. Turned out really yummy. And this is our dinner bowl. So that was it. Tasty.
Oh Lord, please tell me.
Scotty's taking his bath. It's cold, huh?
It's like a self-inflicting pain.
Aja, what is that soap that you gave him?
It's a lavender soap. I forget what it's by Equate, but it is biodegradable.
Biodegradable. Uh-huh. All better?
Now I can sit in my chair and wash my feet.
Yeah, there you go.